हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू मैग्नोटेक यूट्यूब चैनल। फ्रेंड्स, अवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज क्रैंक एंड स्लॉटेड क्विक रिटर्न मैकेनिज्म। ओके, सो दिस मैकेनिज्म इज जनरली यूज इन शेपिंग मशीन एंड स्लॉटिंग मशीन। नाउ फ्रेंड्स, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ शेपिंग मशीन? सो हियर यू कैन सी द टूल इज कनेक्टेड विद द रैम एंड ड्यूरिंग द फॉरवर्ड मोशन और वी कैन से फॉरवर्ड स्ट्रोक, इट्स अ कटिंग स्ट्रोक। इट मीन्स टूल रिमूव द मटीरियल ओके इन अ फॉरवर्ड स्ट्रोक एंड रिटर्न स्ट्रोक इज आइडियल। सो फ्रेंड्स, आवर मोटिव इज टू मेक द रिटर्न स्ट्रोक एज फास्ट एज पॉसिबल। सो फॉर मेकिंग इट फास्ट टू रिटर्न, इट्स कॉल्ड द क्विक रिटर्न मैकेनिज्म। ओके, सो दिस मैकेनिज्म इज यूज फॉर द क्विक रिटर्न मैकेनिज्म फॉर दिस टूल। ओके, नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दिस फिगर। सो हियर टूल कनेक्टेड विद द रैम and RAM is connected with the slotted bar. Okay, you can see here, this is a slotted bar. Okay, so RAM is connected here with the slotted bar through the connecting rod, and in a slotted bar there is a slider, okay, which slide inside the slotted bar, and this slider also connected with the crank to the fixed link. So CA, that is the fixed link. Okay, here this is a fixed link, then this is a crank, it is called a link 2, then slider, it is link 1, and this slotted bar is a link 4. Hope you understand these different links used in here. Now this angle, if we talk about total this angle, okay, this angle is, we can say, return, and beta, you can see here, this is beta, is a forward motion. Okay, when the crank is rotate, so from B1 to B2, it is a forward motion of RAM. Okay, and when this crank come to B2 to B1, it's a return stroke. Okay, so here you can see the time of cutting stroke, that is the beta, and time of return stroke, that is the alpha. And alpha also we can write as a 360 minus beta, okay, because the whole circle angle is 360 minus beta. Also we can write here 360 minus alpha, beta is equal to 360 minus alpha. So I hope you understand these things, right? Now let us talk about this angle. So this angle is alpha by 2. Okay, so C, B1 and A, right, this triangle and this angle, okay, is called the alpha by 2, and this angle is called the 90 minus alpha by 2, because you know total angle is 180. So here this is 90, okay, this is alpha by 2, and this is 90 minus alpha by 2. Okay, so basically you understand this angle. Okay, now here the travel of the tool or length of stroke means, here when this slotted bar, its end position is here, and when it works, here dotted line is given, path is given of this, you know, pivot point P. So here its end point is here P2. So here P1 P2 is equal to R1 R2. Okay, so the path of the total stroke length is called the R1 R2, or we can say P1 P2. Okay, so here P1 P2 is equal to, we can write 2 P1 Q. okay, because Q is here in between, so 2 P1 Q. okay, now 2 P1 Q is equal to, we can write 2 P1 Q is equal to, we can write P1 Q, we can write 2 is as it is, and P1 Q is equal to AP1 sine 90 minus alpha by 2. AP1 sine 90 minus alpha by 2. Okay, so by this figure we can say P1Q is equal to AP1 sine 90 minus alpha by 2. Now sine 90 minus alpha by 2 is equal to cos alpha by 2. Okay, and AP1 is equal to, we can write AP. So AP1 is equal to, it is the same like AP, okay, because this is a just end of this slotted bar. So AP1 is equal to AP. Same way, CB1 is equal to CB because this is a crank. Okay, so CB1 is equal to CB and AC is equal to AC here. Okay, so and cos alpha by 2 here, cos alpha by 2 is equal to, we can write CB1. Okay, this is alpha by 2. So cos alpha by 2 is equal to, we can write CB1 upon AC. Okay, CB1 upon AC. So by this way we can find out the travel of the tool, or we can say length of the stroke. Okay, so basically this figure is very important. By using this figure you can explain this crank and slotted quick return mechanism very, very easily. So friends, hope you like this, and if you have any questions you can message me. Okay, and I will 100% give the answer. And thank you. If you like it, then like, press the button like, share, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.